Innovation has always been the driving force behind evolution. The greatest civilizations have also been the most innovative. The traces left are testimony to this wealth. Innovation can be technological, industrial, or strategic, but also environmental and social. Today, new digital technologies are developing at a speed never seen before and impact all aspects of our lives. More than ever, digital technologies are crucial for developing our economy, creating new jobs, and safeguarding our societies and our values. And Europe is ready. Building a network to facilitate the sharing of digital expertise and infrastructure is the cornerstone of the European Commission's vision. Today, all European companies, public services, and associations must have easy access to Europe's digital experts, infrastructures, and ecosystems that are ready to help them succeed with their digital transformation. This is why the European Digital Innovation Hubs exist, and why the network of European Digital Innovation Hubs will contribute to shaping Europe's digital future. Welcome to Luxembourg and the first European Digital Innovation Hubs conference. Let's gear up.
Good morning and welcome back to our next session. For those who saw the video there, some beautiful pictures of Luxembourg. You can see the wonderful landscape and the business parks that we have. And you can also learn a little bit about some of the projects that are going on here. Just a couple of statistics that came in from our social corner, social media corner. The first hour during Xavier Bettel's speech, we had over 200 tweets. Lots of questions coming in. Apparently the visit around the showroom downstairs, the Institute of Science and Technology, went down very well. We're going to be doing plenty more of that later on, so stay with us. So for the next panel session, which is entitled Championing SMEs to Digitalize, Innovate and Grow, I would like to introduce our moderator, Anne-Marie Sasson, who is the acting head of the digital transformation of industrial ecosystems at DG Connect at the European Commission. Anne-Marie, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, David. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, Digital Innovation Hub community. I saw many known names with people who we work with every day connected to the event. I'm very happy that you do that and that you are so engaged in this endeavor. Thanks a lot also to Lux Innovation to making it possible to have this event. Today, I will be replacing my director, Lucila Scioli, who at the last moment had an emergency and was not able to moderate this panel. However, she will speak tomorrow after the Minister of Economy of Luxembourg, and that way she will still have the opportunity to speak to you and explain how she thinks that this network of European Digital Innovation Hubs will be very important for the European future. We have heard during the speeches today, this morning, that Prime Minister Bettel considers that the investments that Luxembourg has been making in digital infrastructure are a key for the recovery of the crisis. Commissioner Breton, he brought the same message, but he also highlighted the enthusiasm that is surrounded in the joint project that we are all working on together. The Digital Innovation Hubs, regions, countries, and the European Commission. And I also personally, I'm working on this every day, I can also feel this enthusiasm. And that is very promising, and I hope that will really lead to very good results. We've also heard Francesca Bria stating how important it is that we do not only accelerate the digital transformation, but also that we give it a direction, and that we try to include European culture and values in our digital transformation. And that we focus on what matters for us, European citizens and humans. So during this panel, we will hear from a country, from a region, from a digital innovation hub, and from a representative of SMEs, how they will see the impact of the network of European digital innovation hubs for their situation. It is therefore also my pleasure and honor to welcome the panelist on this panel, Professor Christina Sinemus. For the last 2 years, she has been the Minister for Digital Strategy and Development of the region of Hessen in Germany. This is a region with 6.2 million inhabitants and important cities like Frankfurt and Darmstadt. Prior to this role, Professor Sinemus was the managing director and founder of a consulting agency, which was a spin-off of the Technical University of Darmstadt. Our second panelist is Mr. Mario Groots. He is the Director General for Research, Intellectual Property and New Technologies at the Ministry of the Economy of Luxembourg, and also the President of Lux Innovation, the national innovation agency that is today organizing this event. Our third speaker is Ms. Bianca Muntean. She's the manager of the Transylvania IT cluster and the founder and coordinator of the Transylvania Digital Innovation Hub in Cluj in Romania. She has over 20 years of experience in ecosystem development and received several awards for her work, recognized as a European expert by the Commission. And finally, we have Mr. Sebastiano Tovaletti. He is the Secretary General of the European Digital SME Alliance. Digital SME is the Europe's largest association for digital, small and medium-sized enterprises, representing about 20,000 companies. So I'm very happy to have this very good panel here. And my first question to all the panelists would be that, well, we've heard this morning the importance of the uptake of digital innovation by businesses, and that we really need to invest in support infrastructures to help these SMEs. So how do you see the role of the digital innovation hubs in your territory and their networking at European level to overcome the current challenges and become a more resilient digital economy? Ms. Sinemus, could you please give your views on that first?
Yes, I would do this. But first of all, I would like to thank you all very much for the invitation and the great opportunity to participate in this conference. I really appreciate being a part of this valuable and important movement, because I think we have to take in consideration that Europe has to be more on the front running, and this especially in the innovation. Because I think the SMEs are key in the future to be resilient after the crisis. We have to make a chance out of the crisis of the pandemic. And there's a very important innovation, the disruptiveness of the SMEs. So what have we seen? We have an own program in Hessen, which we lay out in my ministry, and there we specific invest in this digital transformation activities of SMEs who can overcome this crisis. For instance, in small teams in universities, in small SMEs who do not get the broad fund of the VCs. So I think, and this is the key, to invest in the digital transformation innovations of the SMEs, and not in only in our region. We have to connect all this all over Europe, and therefore I really appreciate this networking of the European level, and I'm looking forward to get impressions from the other panelists, because I think to make out the chance of the crisis, the key is the SMEs and the digital transformation they bring to us.
Thank you very much. Mr. Mario Groots, can you please elaborate what this would mean for Luxembourg?
Thank you. I think I'm very happy to participate in the initiative. I already had the chance to participate in many of these discussions in Brussels, but also with different countries, and this is a very important initiative for Luxembourg. Let me just give you some background information, therefore, on Luxembourg. I think we developed our innovation strategy in 2019, who is also trying to see how Luxembourg is positioned in the European Union. And what we see is that Luxembourg is very often considered as a front runner, as a digital front runner in Europe, because mainly we are quite strong in IT infrastructure, we are quite strong in connectivity and also in digital skills. However, where we have quite some efforts to do is really on the integration of digital technologies in our industries. This is really, I would say, the weakest point. And in this respect, we really need to help the companies to innovate with this new general purpose digital technologies, be it AI, be it HPC, be it IoT. So this is a very strong focus of our innovation strategy, that we really need to help the companies to experiment and to develop test beds using this general purpose technologies. And in that respect, of course, the Digital Innovation Hub is a very key element of our strategy. We consider the DIH as a kind of platform connecting the needs from the industry with the services offered by our national ecosystem, but not only by our national ecosystem, but also services and providers coming from all over Europe. Our technical or our technology focus is today of our Digital Innovation Hub is today on HPC, cyber, and on artificial intelligence. I think the collaboration with other DIH is very important in that respect. Luxembourg today already is very strong in HPC and on cyber. Even though if we have a clear strategy on AI, I think we still have to ramp up our competences in that respect. And I think the partnership with other DIHs from other regions and from other countries definitely can help us to have a more comprehensive offer for our companies in that area. So in that respect, really the collaboration between the DIH and the partnership with other DIHs are very important. I think we also engaged already with several DIHs. Just to mention that we started discussion with the Saarland, which is quite strong in artificial intelligence, and I think there is a very good complementarity between both regions, so it definitely makes sense to collaborate with them. But for the moment, the discussions are really in a starting phase.
Thank you very much. Now we can hear from a real digital innovation hub, Ms. Bianca Muntian. Can you tell me how you see the role of the digital innovation, of your digital innovation hub in your region and then also at the European level?
Yeah, first of all, it's a great pleasure to see you again. And I really would like to thank you for this opportunity in presenting also the situation here in Romania and in our region. First of all, we really think that this role of having coordination of the digital transformation processes all over Europe, it's quite important because we see a lot of EU initiatives, also national and regional ones. Romania is currently ranking 26th out of 28 last year countries in the European Union, and only 8% of the small medium-sized enterprises are benefiting of the digital transformation for their activity. So this role, which we will play as a European Digital Innovation Hub, will be crucial in order to empower the SMEs, in order to educate them and to offer them access to different type of resources all over Europe and also to the knowledge existing in the European digital innovation hubs. Because we saw also with the pandemic that digitalization is a key element in creating a competitive advantage for our small and medium-sized enterprises. And we will work together with our regional, national, and also European representatives in order to make this digital transformation possible, even for the Romanian SMEs, which have a lot of place to grow from. And we can refer, of course, to this economic transformation, but we cannot ignore also the social and the environmental impact which will take place when this digital transformation will take place within our member SMEs. So by having this orchestration of the innovation experiments, access to test before invest facilities, and most importantly, afterwards, supporting these SMEs to scale up, because our role will not stop when the SMEs will adopt these new technologies, but we will put our efforts and we will coordinate together with the authorities and other DIHs in order to use these technologies for innovation to happen in these SMEs all over Europe. And I think that having these cascade funding examples, the Horizon 2020 project supporting the creation of the pan-European networks, are a great example that this knowledge transfer can happen at the European level. And the upcoming European Network of Digital Innovation Hubs will only enforce and empower the DIHs in their effort to support SMEs' digital transformation all over Europe.
Thank you very much, Bianca. And now, finally, we can hear the voice of the SMEs, and that is, in the end, the reason why we set up this whole support structure. So, Mr. Tovaletti, can you please see how you see the role of the European Digital Innovation Hub for the ICT supplying SMEs and also the other SMEs, of course, who are not suppliers but who would need this support?
Right. Good morning and thank you very much. Well, indeed, as you said, our association, the European Digital SME Alliance, represents a large community of SMEs in the IT sector, SMEs that are providers of digital solutions, very often providing these solutions to other SMEs. So really the B2B engines, the enablers of the digitalization. And those companies that are advancing Europe's also in terms of digital sovereignty, as we heard from Commissioner Breton earlier. Now, we have been obviously working with the Commission in these years, and we have been definitely part of the conversation regarding this important program on the Digital Innovation Hubs. What are our main expectations from these hubs? I will try to summarize in 3 points. Number one, we think the hubs should foster the local ecosystems. What do I mean here? I mean the hubs are not there to reinvent the wheel. Hubs should be grassroots organizations that help the local companies, the IT providers, work with the non-IT companies, and together they grow the ecosystem. Therefore, the hubs should, you know, raise awareness, demonstrate technologies, and support the local providers. Not replace the local IT providers, because this is not the job of hubs. Number two of our priorities is for the hubs to foster Europe's digital sovereignty, as we heard from Commissioner Breton. How? Well, first of all, the digital industry in Europe is very often small and fragmented compared to counterparts in US and China. But every region has many hidden local digital champions. They're very advanced and very successful in their own niche technology. So the hubs should help these smaller companies to work together, creating consortia and networks with other companies because by doing so, they will consolidate and they will be able to offer more complex, more vertically integrated solutions that can possibly later on compete with the foreign giants. We have good examples here. We have the Digital Hub Aachen, who's very active in that. We also have the Cluj IT in Romania. We heard a previous speaker from Romania. I want to mention Cluj IT is a very, very strong and grassroots hub over there. And third point is focus on scalability and transferability. So each hub is not working in isolation, as we heard from many other speakers. We have an example here of a project funded by the Commission, EU Hubs for Data. This project runs a sort of coordination of digital innovation hubs that which are active in big data. And what they aim to do here is work together, but especially give access to common data sets, such that one hub does not work alone, but they have access to data sets from other hubs as well. And this is actually a nice idea of a pilot for the future European data spaces that the Commission has announced that will take place in different sectors. So thank you.
Thank you, Sebastiano. So what I heard is that, so for all of you, you are already engaged and developing programs to help SMEs with their digital transformation, but you would really like also to learn from others or to use other competences and resources that are available in other regions of Europe. And so that this networking of the European Digital Innovation Hubs, what is the aim, is something very important and will really bring a lot of added value to your work at the local level. What we also heard is that the hub should really focus also the local ecosystem and know them very well and have a good engagement also with ICT suppliers who could then really be an active part of the ecosystem, help also users that are companies that are not ICT knowledgeable, and that they can then further innovate together. So that local champions, they will then at the end also get an opportunity to work maybe also with companies in other regions through the network of the Digital Innovation Hub, and that they will be able to scale up, because it's not only the adoption of the digital technology, but it's also the scaling up that needs to be supported. These are the things that I have heard you say. I want to say to the audience that it is possible to ask questions and answers to the participants in the chat, in the Q&A, I must be more precise. And you can also vote for the questions, so that then the most popular questions will come on top, and that I will be able to ask these questions to the panelists. So please use that opportunity, because even though we are online, we would still hope that the event would be a bit interactive. So I would like to ask another question to the panelists, and I start again with Professor Sinemus. So what is the importance of the European Digital Innovation Hubs for Hessen? You already have really a dynamic region. You have a strong industrial ecosystem. Which is really the European added value that you see and the synergies that you need to make the Hessen economy grow further?
Thank you for the question. I think a lot of the aspects are already mentioned from the other panelists. I want to raise two aspects. The first is we need to have a kind of a bottom-up process. That means the local ecosystem is the key for having a European networking at the end of the day. So the scale-up and the transferability of the aspects which are in the local ecosystem are the future clue for being a cooperative partner. So we in Hessen have two strong consortia, both from Northern and Southern Hessen, and they applied for the project. They have different different competencies and strengths. The one in the South is more on the artificial intelligence and cybersecurity. That means we could easily cooperate with, for instance, Luxembourg and Saarland, because this AI activities in the SMEs and the cybersecurity, looking at it on the European wide network, there will be a huge added value if we are collaborate together. If we are looking more in the north, there we have a local ecosystem which really focus on the transferability of SME activities in the industry 4.0. That means in the medium-sized companies. So, and when we there can cooperate over the regions, over Hessen, in all the European countries together, with especially this focus, then at the long term, I think we have that what all of us want to have. We have a European-wide networking, which itself is a huge added value for all of us, because we can scale it up, we have a transferability, and we have a cooperation in building up a network. And that's what we want to do, bring our local ecosystem information and strengths in a European network. So at the end of the day, Europe is strong for the future.
Thank you very much. Mr. Groot, how do you see that the services of the National Luxembourg European Digital Innovation Hub can address the needs from all the companies in Luxembourg, so all the sectors that you have represented? How do you see this would be possible?
Yes. Maybe first reaction, very happy to hear what Hessen is doing. I think they are definitely very, very complementary what we are doing. I think our national strategy, as I said before, is really focusing on the integration of digital technologies in industry. So we're really in the heart of Industry 4.0. How can we help our companies to transit more rapidly to business model links to Industry 4.0, and of course AI and cybersecurity play a very important role in that respect. So in our heart of our strategy is really manufacturing industry, and how can we help the whole industry to realize a transition towards Industry 4.0. I think the main element, or the strong element of the Luxembourg Digital Innovation Hub, is its partnership. It has been said before and stressed out before that we need to have a partnership which also reflects the ecosystem, and this is exactly what we try to achieve with our partnerships. It is a partnership of six different partners. Of course, Lux Innovation is one of the partners operating also the Digital Innovation Hub, but then there is also the university and the LIST. The LIST is the RTO, the national RTO in Luxembourg. So there's a National Research Fund, there's a National Chamber of Commerce, and there is also the FIDIL, which is the voice of industry. And all these actors really have, I think, the necessary competences and also the network in order to the network to the industry in order to really build up the competences. Of course, the university and LIST more when it comes to the development of technology and when it comes to the training activities. Lux Innovation is more the entity who really has a network with all the companies and really has as a main role to help the companies to implement digital projects and innovative projects. The FIDIL is more the federation which really represents the industry in Luxembourg. So with this partnership, we have all the elements in place in order to ramp up the competences in Luxembourg. So it is a federated approach which really helps us to build these companies. And I think all these actors already have their links to the European counterparts, which should also allow us to engage more easily with European partners.
Thank you very much. So the choice of the consortium for the European Digital Innovation is very important, of course, to be able to play the role that they should play. So, Ms. Muntiam, so you now founded a Digital Innovation Hub and you are also managing a cluster. So how would you see the synergies between the work of a cluster and the work of a European Digital Innovation Hub?
Yeah, we've been working already for some time in putting together a set of competencies and capabilities as a cluster. I would like to start by saying that the situation and the level of maturity of different ecosystems, it's not the same all over Europe. So not having such a long experience in building up ecosystem working, for us it's great that we've already reached this step, this important step. And our work as a Digital Innovation Hub came as a continuation, a natural continuation of our efforts made as a cluster. Because as previous speakers already mentioned before, it is really, really important to work within local regional ecosystems. And I really think it's about ecosystems and not ego systems. And there is so much work to do for the benefit all of the small and medium-sized enterprises. So we as a cluster, we did nothing else than put at the benefit of creating Transylvania Digital Innovation Hub all the knowledge we've gathered in the past 8 years by working together very close with small and medium-sized enterprises. And while reaching as a cluster the IT companies, the solution providers, which are well known all over Europe and world, we were very happy to also have the collaboration and very close support of our colleagues from the clusters representing other fields of small and medium-sized enterprises like agriculture, furniture, creative industries, energy, new materials. So for us, working together in this ecosystem for more than 7 years, it became really natural to build our Digital Innovation Hub on the pillars created by the clusters acting here in northwestern region in Romania. And also what I would like to mention is the great importance and very active involvement of the research institutes. We have a very strong physical research institute which is involved in research in quantum computing, for example, and also Babes-Bolyai University and Technical University from Cluj, which is known and has great contacts all over Europe. And another important element, I would say, is the strong support and direct involvement of Cluj City Hall, Cluj Municipality, under the leading of Mayor Bock, which offers, for example, the infrastructure part in our Digital Innovation Hub. So coming from the cluster level, where we created a base of trust among different type of actors, SMEs, universities, research institutes, public administration, it is a great base for building up and coming up with services on digital transformation under the umbrella of Transylvania Digital Innovation Hub. Because it's all about orchestration. It's not about what organization is more important or that there is one organization more important than the other in the Digital Innovation Hub, but it's about putting together resources, competencies, capabilities, projects, in order to make this digital transformation process work and to have a great reach to our small and medium-sized enterprise at regional, national, and European level.
Thank you, Bianca. So now, Sebastiano, I have a question to you. How do you see the role of industry associations, such as yourself, related to the network of European digital innovation hubs? How would you like to be involved?
Thank you, Anne-Marie. It's a good question indeed, and it's a chance for us also to say what we are doing in this respect. Of course, we do look forward to the development of the digital innovation hubs, because they will actually really help our companies to foster. What we have to offer in there is a few things. Number one, you know, our extensive membership of, you know, SMEs. We have a community of over 20,000 companies across Europe, and our national members, which are associations and clusters, they have already established their own hubs. And so we have, you know, number two, we have already a very, very large group of hubs which we are coordinating, or organizations that, you know, are going to run for the hub, for the calls, and we are coordinating these organizations. We have our working group on digitalization, which is actually doing the coordination of digital innovation hubs. I mentioned earlier Cluj IT and Digital Innovation Digital Hub Aachen. Let me also mention Digitech in Bulgaria, Diagoria Innovation Center in Belgium, EDI by Confcommercio in Italy, and so on. So there are really many. Number three, we have been involved, and we want to be involved in some strategic projects at European level. I mentioned earlier EU Hubs for Data, which is really a very great opportunity to provide a coordination of the digital innovation hubs involved in big data. So if anyone in the audience is involved in any hub which focuses on big data, please get in touch with us, because we already have now 10 hubs which are working with this coordination project, but we want to aim for many, many more. And four, to finish, as part of our services as an association, we offer information about funding and funding opportunities to SMEs and to their associations. So we have a lot of information about open calls for SME digitalization and to further the innovation of digital companies and non-digital companies. Thus, we help digital innovation hubs to share this information with their companies and with their network.
Thank you, Sebastiano. So what I hear from all of you is that, again, you look forward to the collaboration. It's very good to connect all the different initiatives together, all the things where the people you are all working on. And that can really bring a very good European added value. And we should really build on existing strengths that exist and then learn more from the others. I would now like to turn to the questions in the pen that the people in the audience have raised. And let me see. The most popular question is of Thomas Ludwig. I have to read it. It's a long question. I think what he is trying to ask is, should a digital innovation hub focus on very deep collaborations with SMEs, or should they to be more, let's say, shallow and focus on more types of SMEs to support? So what kind of expertise is required? Does it has to be very deep knowledge on all these technologies, or should it be more, general knowledge on all these technologies and understand how it will be applicable to SMEs. Who would like to answer this question? Maybe Bianca?
Yes, I think that it's really important to have both ways covered. That is why, for example, in our Transylvania Digital Innovation Hub, in our governance structure, we have 12 members which offer different type of services and approaches within the hub. So while the cluster may have an increasing interest to have a greater outreach to reach as many SMEs wherever in Romania in terms of promoting and increasing awareness regarding the benefits of digital transformation, the competence centers, the research institutes will be more interested to focus and to deepen the discussion on specific topics, like, for example, like high-performance computing or artificial intelligence, or like I've mentioned before, quantum computing. So the ideal way is to have both parts covered, the outreaching, because it's really, really important to create impact in our efforts for the digital transformation, but also we have to create this specialism and to bring forward the great knowledge and expertise existing in our universities, competence centers, and research facilities.
Thank you. Another question that came from the panel. Should we support more front runners or should we support more laggards? To say so. Who would like to answer this question? Maybe Mr. Groot?
Yes, I think at the end the question is probably we should support both. And it's a little bit related to the question before also. I think what we need to create inside the Digital Innovation Hub is really competences which allow us to really understand what are the needs of the companies. And for some companies, it's really more, more very basic needs in order to digitalize. On other companies, it is really more, it gets more sophisticated when we are talking about new business models based on data. And so the importance is for us to really have the people on board at the DIH which really understands both sides and then can make the link to the relevant partners. At some point of time, it will be more the universities which will help to collaborate and develop the right innovation models. On the other side, it might also, at some point of time, for SMEs, for smaller SMEs, be more the idea to make the link to the service providers and just to help them to get on the next level of digitalization. So it is probably, we should try to address both sides.
Okay, thank you very much.
I would like to add one idea. I think the panelists already said both sides, deep knowledge and application, front runners and latency. If you see on the key success factor of digitalization, I think the interdisciplinarity is a key factor for the future of the European Digital Innovation Hubs, because digitalization itself has so many perspectives that the interdisciplinary knowledge and background from the different teams and the SMEs is a key.
Thank you very much for that, those wise words.
Can I also
we are at the end of the panel and the timing ended. I saw there was another question on can you give some success stories? For that, I would like to refer to the different sessions that we will have this afternoon and tomorrow, because there will be still many examples of good practices and of success stories. So now I would like to end the panel. And I would like to build on the last thing that was said by Professor Sinemus is that indeed we should focus on laggards and also front runners. we should sometimes have deep knowledge, sometimes we should have more general knowledge. We can achieve that by building the right consortium of a European Digital Innovation Hub. And this should be really interdisciplinary because there are so many perspectives. It's a very challenging task to support all the SMEs, but the network of the European Digital Innovation Hub will then also allow that you can learn from others, you can replicate best practices that you see somewhere else, you can collaborate, and we in Europe, that way we can get really good at supporting our SMEs with their digital transformation. So I want to thank all the speakers for this very interesting panel. And thanks to all the listeners. And I think now there is a break. And then I hand over to David.
Thank you very much, Anne-Marie. That was very insightful. Thank you also to the other panelists. A very nice view of how we see the vision of these hubs coming together. There is a break coming up, but before we do that, if I can ask our production to put me onto this little thing, I have a bit of a surprise for us. Okay, let's see, here we go. Okay, so here we are in the office. We can see the studio here. Mario is giving us a little hi. And what we're going to do now is have a little bit of a walk around and see what we can find. So first the thing, oh, I forgot to tell you about this. Tomorrow we have the Digital Innovation Hub Challenge. So these are the two awards for the winners in here. Let me see if I can open the door with my foot. We have all the guys with all of that really exciting technological stuff that is making everything happen for us today. Let's go across. Oh, I've got a good idea. We'll try and gate crash the CEO later. Here is our social media corner. Is everybody working hard? Let's see. Let's see what's happening. Marina, do you have something for us to see? Let's have a look. Wow, goodness, what is all that? Those are all the people logged in?
Yeah.
And you can see where they're coming from. Wow. How many people do we have online? Do you know now?
1,530.
1,530 concurrent users. There's my Twitter handle if somebody wants to connect in. Just looking out the window, we can see one of the blast furnaces of Belleville. So this was from 1909 when this place was the economic central of Luxembourg. Let me see what I have here from Laurent. A big hi from Jean-Jacques. Bonjour Strasbourg. Rosanna from Digital Cultural Center in Milan. Marcin from Medical University Poland. Where are we going? Let's go down here. So within Lux Innovation, so we're the National Agency for Innovation and Research. This is where we have our cluster managers. So each one running our cluster. So in here, for example, we would have, obviously there's no one here, they're all remote working. We have our creative industries, automotive. In here we have composites. In here we have a wood cluster. Let's just say hi to Philippe. Hi, Philippe, you're live, don't swear. Okay. I've always wanted to say that. through here we have our market intelligence, very useful tool for certainly for the business development, but also for the sector mapping. Then we're going through the corridor. Over here we have, I hope I'm not walking too fast to make everybody sick. This is where we have our national funding teams and what used to be the Horizon 2020s. Here we have Benjamin, who's our strategic advisor. You're live on the feed with 1,500 people watching you. Give us a smile.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Luxembourg.
And he's going to be on a panel a bit later. Here we have people working for digitalization and SME growth. There's Christophe. He's our IT manager. He's making all this happen in the background, but not forgotten. Okay, let's see over here. Oh, dear.
Let's see if we can. Oh, it was Sasha Bailey, our CEO. Let's see. Hi, Sasha. It's David here. Again, I'm going to say it a bit like Big Brother. You're live. Please don't swear.
I knew you were coming.
I've been following. Hang on a second. I'm going to take off here. Hopefully, you can still hear Sasha.
Hello.
So, Sasha is the CEO of Lux Innovation.
Great.
Tell me, Sasha, what is a typical day of a CEO in a national research and innovation
company? Well, today is not a typical day. I've been following you guys online, and it's just fantastic to see it all come together. To see all those people following all the comments. It's fantastic because you really see all the connection and all this know-how in Europe. And we need to break those silos, and it's all happening right now. When Natalie came in and just gave me the thumbs up and it's technologically all working, we were all a bit nervous when we saw these registrations going on. But it's fantastic. It means that we can function digitally, but it will be great learning for the future physically too. So good. That's been my day today.
So not a typical day, like you said. Let me just put my microphone back in. Do you mind if I look out your window?
Sure.
Let's have a look, see what's happening. I hope my microphone cut over okay. So here's the old Belval site. So this was Arbed, which then became ArcelorMittal. You can see the Technoport, the national incubator down there. Just in the distance is the university, but we'll go and see that a little bit later on. Incidentally, and I'm just going to go outside. Thank you, Sasha. See you shortly. Let's go and have a look over here. We were talking about Arcelor and Arbed and what have you. So that over there actually is still a steel plant that's very active. They take out to the steel girders on the train track. You can just see the guys in their high res down there. And you can find these steel girders pretty much all the way around the world. I was actually in Toronto once, and there was a steel girder on a building site at Luxembourg written down the side of it, which was quite amazing. There's leftovers from our kiddies party. And with that, I'm going to cut off here. Let's meet back at 11:15 for our discussion on forging European collaboration. So take a little break, make yourself a nice cup of coffee, and I'll see you back after the break. Thank you. ¶¶